welcome to Guide to Witchcraft episode 6, Aqua Spirit 16. And before I tell you today's topic, I guess we could call it that. Okay, so before I tell you what today's topic is, I just wanted to say sorry, I haven't uploaded anything in 2 months. Some crap happened with my YouTube account, so yeah. Anyway, I see I haven't gotten any requests or anything. Please, if you have any idea as to what videos you'd like me to make to show you how to do stuff, assuming I know how to do it. But yes, anyway, if you have any ideas as to what you would like me to show you to do, please let me know. Now this next sentence is probably going to sound really sad to you guys, but I'm so proud. I saw I had one comment on one of my videos, the hair growth spell, and yes, all the spells that I show you to do, how to do, I always practice them first, so I know 100% that they work. Anyway, what I was going to show you guys to do today is with circle casting. As you all should know, when you cast a circle, you have to invoke the four elements and the god and goddesses. And I find when I cast a circle, if the salt and the water have been blessed first, it makes a more powerful circle that draws in more energy and also somewhat safer. So, which brings me to what I will show you today. I will show you how to bless and yeah, blah, blah, blah. Anyway, what I will show you today is how to bless and cleanse water and salt. Now, water is a very psychic energy and it can pick up different vibrations and energies. Of course, it depends whether you get it from the tap, from a light shower outside, or a thunderstorm. So with the water, you need to bless it. Also, you need to cleanse it. You need to get the bad vibrations, the bad energies out of the water. Salt, on the other hand, all you have to do is bless it. So that's actually no, it's not that much easier. So first I will show you how to bless and cleanse water. So obviously the first thing you need is a jar or a cup or a bowl of water, and then also you need your wand. Well, it's pretty basic. Or you can, instead of a wand, you can use a thame. So once you have your wand and a thame, all you need is to sit down in a comfortable position and put your wand or a thame into the water and visualize the energy coming up from the ground through your body, through your arms, through your hand, into your wand and going into the water. Imagine beautiful purple lights and how you imagine like peace, and just imagine the energy, all the positive energy flowing into the water. Now once again, I'm not taking credit for this ritual or spell. It is someone else's. I'm just relaying it on, but I'm actually currently working on spells of my own. I love to write, and so I'm creating chants and spells of my own, and they're actually working out pretty well. So soon I'll be uploading some of my own homemade spells. So now, pardon the view, but so you put your wand or a thame into the water and you imagine the energy flowing in, and then close your eyes and simply chant, "I exercise thee, a creature of water, that there be no negativity or unwanted energy contained within me. In the name of the Lady and the Lord, so mote it be, for the night of pentacles." There you have it. Of the water. Now I will show you the salt. Once again, pardon the view. So the salt's pretty much the exact same thing. You grab your wand or a thame, you put it into the salt, and you visualize the energy coming up through your body, through your arm, through your hand, through your wand or a thame, into the salt. And then you just simply chant, "I bless thee, O creature of salt. In the name of the Lady and the Lord, enrich, bless, and ground this ritual. So mote it be." So there you have it, a couple of chants to exercise and cleanse and bless the water. and Bless the Salt. Hope you like it, hope you found it useful. And once again, please feel free to give me any ideas as to what I should put my next video. And that's all for today. Thanks and blessed be.